I'll be showing 11 new updates in Teams for Education. This includes the new Copilot Chat, which is also available for students who are 13 and above now, feedback and grading updates, a bunch of Learning Accelerator improvements, and a whole lot more. So let's get started. The first new feature is that Copilot Chat is built directly into Teams. So on the left app bar here, you're gonna see Copilot. And I'll click this. And this is the Copilot Chat that's available in all Microsoft 365 versions, both in commercial and education. It's got enterprise data protection. You can see here in the upper right. I can collapse this if I just wanna see the chat window. We'll expand that again. Now a note, this is not the full Microsoft Copilot, that $30 a month version. This is the version that just goes against web data. But I can do things like write a message to send to my team that talks about the new TPS report cover sheets, do it in the style of Bill Lumberg. All right, here's a message in the classic Bill Lumberg style. About those TPS report cover sheets. So you can do all those same types of things. You get the thumbs up, thumbs down. You can read it out loud.
Sure thing, Mike. Here's a message in classic Bill Lumberg style that...
And if I want to create a new chat, I can go right here. You've got some recommendations on ways to get started. You can see more, you know, what are analysts saying about some competitor this quarter. So lots of great interactions. I'm not going to go deep into this, but it is Copilot Chat. It's all available. You can add content, etc. You can also go and get agents. And there's lots of different agents that you can get. I can also create my own agents, either this button here or click Create Agent. This lets you use existing agents here, or I can configure my own agent. And I'm not gonna do the entire process, but right now this will go against the web because this is the free version of Copilot Chat. You can add different prompts and create your agents. We've got different videos on that. But this is just to show that you have the full Copilot Chat right here inside of Teams. The second new feature is update to this grid view when you're an educator or staff member using Teams for Education. You can see now on the classes, we have little links to drill into announcements, assignments, or classwork right from this grid square. So for science, if I want to go into classwork, I am now directly in my classwork right from that grid. We'll go back. I can go directly into things like assignments. So here are my science assignments with one click. Or I can go to announcements in that general channel. The third new feature is left rail sizing in any team you have. So right here, I'm gonna hover and I'm gonna get the little splitter bar. I can make that wider or smaller, or I can even collapse it. So this is a nice time saver, this fully collapsed rail, really easy to do now. The fourth new feature is a tips pane for educators as well as students. So if I go into assignments right here in my class team, over on the right, there's a little light bulb and it'll get a little red dot when there are new tips, but I can open this up at any time. And there's all sorts of great tips using learning accelerators and reading coach, for example, rubrics with AI, how to use Copilot. And there's a learn more link to jump off and get information on how to use these great tips. It can be tips. It can be training. If you want to know what's new, great stuff here. So this is a great way for educators who might want to learn about the latest features or get tips. Similarly, we're rolling this out for students. So when they're in the assignments area, they'll also have this light bulb. And again, it'll pop up with a red dot when there's something brand new that shows up. The fifth new feature is an enhanced feedback area in the grading component for your assignments. So I'm an educator here and I've got an assignment that I've put out, and Alex Wilber right here, he has turned in his assignment. So I'm gonna open this up. And over on the right-hand side, you're gonna see feedback. So when I click in here, one thing you'll notice is now there's a bold, italics, underlined, highlighter, and a couple other options. So if I put in some feedback, we'll underline, we'll give a few things for bullets. We'll give some bullets there. What's also nice is if I want a little more space, I can expand this, and we have a lot more characters that can be added into this feedback panel. So if I want to have a bunch of things, I'm just going to expand, expand, expand. You have a lot more area. It used to just be pretty packed in there. You couldn't do anything in terms of highlighting, and you couldn't do anything in terms of bullets and bold and italic. The sixth new feature is the top request for reading progress, and that is the ability to have the reading passage and the comprehension questions show up for the student side by side. And I'm gonna show how to set this up on the teacher side first, and then we'll show the student side. So I'll click Create and Learning Accelerators and choose Reading Progress. And I'm gonna browse the sample library and I will choose a passage. We'll choose a camping trip and I'll choose Select. Okay, here's the passage right here. Now I'm gonna choose to add a comprehension set of questions. And when I do that, this is the comprehension dialogue. This is the same it's always been. You could add your own, but I will choose to generate questions, and I'll choose three here and hit next. So now it's generating some questions for my passage. Okay, here are the questions that it generated. And what I want to do is there's this new checkbox, allow students to see questions next to the passage. Okay, this looks good. At the top, I'll hit next. And now I'll give it a title. Okay, and I'm going to assign this passage out to my student. Okay, now I'm signed in as the student, and here's my reading passage. We'll open this up, and I'll open up the camping trip passage. Hey, there I am. I'm just going to quickly read through this. There's my countdown. Ryan and his family went camping. Now we're going to speed up, and we're going to pretend that I'm all done. I'll click I'm done. Okay, we'll use this recording. Now it's going to upload, and now what you're going to see is the comprehension questions next to the reading passage. And here you go. Here's the reading passage on the left, and here's the comprehension questions on the right. The seventh new feature is another reading progress update, and that is theming and avatars for a reading coach. So let's pretend that I'm going to do my comprehension questions right here and fill them out and submit. Hit submit. Okay, now at the bottom, I'll click on reading coach.
These words were the most challenging for you. Select any word to tackle them again.
Now, the first thing you're going to notice is this is a nice, pretty, shaded, sort of an indigo and blue, and you can see these buttons on the bottom are larger than they used to be, so it used to be pretty boring and black and white. Now it's much more colorful and a little bit larger. The other nice thing is I can go into settings right here, and now I can choose my avatar. So maybe I want an octopus, I can choose this one, Rio, I can choose no coach. If you have older students, maybe they don't want a coach at all. Maybe that they feel that these little avatars are a little too young. So maybe I just want a basic one. In this case, hit save. So now this is a little more simple. You can also go in here and choose pronunciation, change your own sensitivity, the feedback, supportive versus direct, or even the different sounds. You can choose a male voice. If you don't like Jenny, you've got Brian and Andrew and Ava. So students can have a lot more customization of the reading coach. The eighth new feature is the ability to upload PowerPoint decks for your speaker progress assignments. This is one of our newest learning accelerators. And if you haven't seen speaker progress, I've got a deep dive video on that. The link to that is in the upper right. It's also in the description. So on the educator side, we're going to really quickly create a speaker progress assignment. Okay, we'll set the number of attempts for 5, time limit 10 minutes. And I'm going to go down here. We're going to select all for all these different speaker coach options. Maybe I want to turn off inclusiveness and pronunciation, so you can see those change right there. Okay, my speaker progress assignment is all ready on the educator side. I'll hit next. We'll give it a quick title. Okay, everything's all ready. Now I'll hit assign. Now we'll sign in as the student and show what that looks like to add that PowerPoint deck on the student side. I'm signed in as the student, and here is that speaker progress assignment right here from the teacher. I'm going to go in here and open up my speaker progress assignment. Now what you're going to see is upload PowerPoint deck. Now I'm going to upload this deck so I can practice my PowerPoint presentation while I'm presenting. Okay, it's uploading my file. This just might take a moment. Okay, getting my presentation ready. Okay, now it's going to ask me to have Teams see this tab. I'll hit allow. Great, and it is sharing, and it's going to share and record everything I go through. This is my What's New in Microsoft EDU presentation. That's what my speaker progress is on, and I'll click start. Hey, now I'm presenting in PowerPoint. This is What's New in EDU. And I'm going to go to the next slide right here. I can see the agenda. Now in the lower right, I can choose to see all slides, or I can also see my notes. So if I have notes on the slides, I don't have notes on this slide, but in the lower left, your notes could show up. So the student now could get real-time coaching feedback. They can do their entire PowerPoint presentation. They can have their notes. They can even see all their slides if they want. So I have a bunch of different slides here, so I can navigate. I can go at the bottom. I can close this. If I have things where I'm speaking too fast, or I say, and now it's Miss, and there's my coaching. Avoid fillers such as all that other great stuff. This is all part of the PowerPoint inside of Speaker Progress. The ninth new feature are new languages supported in Speaker Progress. So I will click Create and Learning Accelerators and choose Speaker Progress again. Now on the right-hand side, you're going to see a drop-down and you're going to see a bunch of new languages that are right in here. So Spanish, Polish, Portuguese, and a whole lot more. We're also adding even more languages coming in September. I've got a slide on the screen that shows on the right-hand side some of the newest languages that are going to be coming. So stay tuned, we're going to support more and more folks with speaker progress. The 10th new feature is AI feedback in speaker progress. And this is AI narrative feedback is what we call it. So first we're going to select all the different things that we want to be captured in this speaker progress assignment. And this is in private preview now, but by September, this should be rolling out globally to anyone who uses speaker progress. So if I turn on AI narrative feedback, I can say, what is the speech type? Informative, personal, or persuasive. So for example, if I chose informative, it's going to give me feedback based on that. I can do a personal speech or persuasive. So if I choose informative, now I can select the AI feedback. So what's going to happen is, on the educator side, after the presentation is done and recorded, AI is going to look at the transcript, and I can choose things like rhetorical techniques, style, message clarity, emotional or intellectual appeal, or I could just select all the categories. It's up to me. So I've selected a few here, and now I click done. So what's going to happen is right here, it adds AI feedback. There's different categories of delivery, content, and audience engagement. Students will receive targeted and personalized feedback on their speech according to these criteria. And again, this drafts it up, and we'll show what this looks like on the educator side. So the educator doesn't have to do anything. They could choose to use that feedback or not for the student. So I'm going to go now and turn in an assignment as a student, and we'll flip back to the educator afterwards and show what does that AI feedback look like. But first I'll hit next and we'll make this assignment. We're going to have an informative speech, and we will click assign. Okay, now we've sped up. I'm gonna go into this informative speech. I'm the educator, and it looks like Alex Wilbur has turned his in. Let's open this up. Now here is the main report, Alex Wilbur's rehearsal report. You can see the entire video recording is right here. Hello, welcome to What's New in Microsoft EDU. Pause that and make it a little bit smaller so you can see the entire PowerPoint deck was recorded. I was talking. Here's all the main opportunities and strengths. Now the AI feedback is in the transcript tab. So I'm gonna switch to this. Now here is the transcript. There's a nice summary. It was informative, covered a lot of ground. I did a nice intro, etc. Now it highlights parts about the content. So you can see the green here, it's highlighted. The feedback, this sentence is a bit convoluted and could be clearer. Consider breaking it into shorter sentences, etc. I've got one here that is all about delivery. It's powerful, it's protective, we'll open that up. This sentence effectively emphasizes the strengths of Copilot Chat. The repetition of its has a rhythmic flow and enhances the message. Great job! And then audience engagement. This is highlighted here. You can see the little purple. That's audience engagement, like that. What does it say here? While this sentence provides a lot of information, it could be more engaging. So a lot of AI-generated feedback. You can see here, AI-generated content may be incorrect. We always make sure we put that out there. You can give a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Hey, I thought this was good AI generated content. I could submit this. And if I want to edit anything, right? If I want to edit the summary, I can go here and I can tweak this. You know, maybe I want to add something else. I could add additional thoughts and hit save. So the educator is in control of all this transcript feedback, but this is quite powerful and this can speed up the entire process of giving rich and powerful feedback for these speaker progress assignments. The 11th new feature is the ability to add graphs or images to math progress questions. So for this learning accelerator, I'll choose create, learning accelerators and math progress, which is one of our newer ones. If you want a deeper dive into math progress, in the upper right, there's a link to that video. I'm just gonna go and create my own question to simplify this, and I will click add question. We'll choose a category, we'll do expressions and equations, and then we'll choose linear equations. So I'll add the quick question. What is the equation for this line? If I click attach, I could choose to add an image. So this is new. I could upload from Teams or OneDrive or my device. I could also attach a graph. So if I click here, now I've got a nice graph and I'm going to put in my equation. And it automatically will put this line here and I can actually go and hover, get all the coordinates. I can choose to show the equation on the actual graph. I'm not going to do that. We also have the math calculator right in here that's got all sorts of great stuff in it. I'll just say attach graph. And there we go. So now I can have a graph or I could choose images and you can put in all the other pieces here as part of the normal math progress follow through.